terminal illness. My entire aura is sick. A belligerent alcoholic, paraplegic. That means I drink till I can't walk. Suicide king, I outline myself in chalk. I'm no longer to battle, it's just for reputation. I'm all about airborne plagues and cell mutation. Face it against AIDS to see who lasts the duration. My favorite machine, the greatest gang.
There we go. Welcome to G13.
Hey.
It's 13. Then let me host my own show. Erg 7, so love, headed off the torch. And I'm here to ask what made it. Orders full out the paper and pen disorder. Mess of life, start writing again. Season 1, Damon Contrell, Little Ratchet, Magnif, New Legends, Erg 7, Habit of God. The Kid Ace, King Nephew, Mike, Sir Black, Rock Blocks, Angel Sandoval. All hustle hard to get money using God given artistry. Welcome to the Hungry.
Right here, Rock Box,
what's up,
Nephew.
How you guys doing in here?
Yeah, man. Glad to be here, man. Glad to be here, man. Thank you, God, for that. We still here, really.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. You know what I mean?
Tell me about yourself, guys. Where you guys come from? See the
Linwood
on the
T-shirt
right here.
Linwood, man. Spot between Compton and Watts. Yeah, you know what I mean? And that's what we represent. We also represent the West Coast.
That's what's up. You guys
live
down Linwood your whole life?
I've been
living in Manwood basically my whole life, and the thing about it is he lived right across the street from me.
That's right.
So you know, we grew up in high school together, man, and in Manwood.
Oh, so you guys aren't related.
That's
crazy. That family vibe from y'all. I thought y'all was like brothers and cousins or something like that. You know what I'm saying?
Like, right across from each other. Right. And the blessing of it is, we grew up in the same environment, but it just shows you, man. When you look at us, it shows you that sometimes we make choices. Because even though we grew up in the same hood, we grew up on the same street. I gang banged, and he took the different route and went and fought for this country. So you know that's the blessing, man. And we both got a testimony to give, man.
And then y'all combine that, so you guys combine when you do music, right?
Yeah.
I listened to some of your tracks earlier. You like to sing,
yeah.
You flow, and you get your thing on. And how'd you guys come across that? How'd you guys start this whole style?
Well, 2013, and then around 2014, I just started doing a lot of shows everywhere. And, you know, it was other rappers from Linwood and stuff like that. They were saying they doing this and doing that. But I was like, I don't see y'all out there. I'm out there all the time, you know. So I got on Facebook one day, man, and I had called basically. I was talking to all the Linwood.
Yeah.
You know, I'm out here, like, man. I'm in the mix, man. Come on and try it, man. I'm doing my thing, man. Come on with me, man. I'll tell you, whatever I got, you got. Let's do it.
Right.
Only person responding. Nephew Mike.
No lie.
Everybody, I heard somebody else here and there, but he responded. He was like, man, what's up? I'm down. I was like, okay. We hooked up, and I've just been nonstop ever since. And then, like, and what was the trip part was about it was that when I first got back, I hooked up with my boy Juke LD, you know, from the original Ryan Rocker production team. You know, I'll get into that in a minute. But the first CD I heard from him was Nephew Mike.
Back, he's like the first.
Yeah, he was the first one.
Nice to
just
on
the universe, man.
Yeah, this was before, you know.
Yeah, before you guys even thought about
transition.
Before I transitioned over, because you know.
Always say you used to do something before.
No,
like,
I rapped
back in the day with Bokey Loke, which is CPO's little brother, and Scratch Lou from Imperial Court. Moss Bird was in our crew at that time before he got, you know, signed his record deal. He was all with the Street Scholar Entertainment back then in Compton. You know, I was a gangster rapper. You know what I mean? A gangbanger, gangster rapper, making rap for the hood and all that type of stuff. And I had one of my little homeboys, Young Thurs from Linwood, man, was doing some music. He like, big homie, come back. Cause I had to quit rapping. I wasn't with it. I was good. I'm old. But anyway, I gave my life to God, man. And he asked me to come back into the game with him and help him with his mixtape. But in the process of me doing gangster rap with him, I'm like, man, I'm 40-something years old. I ain't got no business talking about no shoot 'em up, gang banging and all that. That's right. I got grandkids. I accepted Christ, man, so I changed. I changed the music. So I changed my rap style to positive, inspirational gospel. Every song on this CD is true testimony. And then I got in the choir at church a couple of years ago, man, and realized that I had a couple of notes I can do. So I put it all together, man, to get a message. Rockbox, when we were in high school in the 80s, you know, you had lunchtime, we see the whole crowd at lunch. Run and make a circle. So we like, they battle rapping over here. You know, we were in high school. And we get over there and rock box with beatbox, rap and freestyle and tear the show up all the time in the talent shows. That's and we up. Brought that back together. Like, you know, the new music has changed, but I love funk music. I play drums, so I love funk music. And he's a hip hop from way back. I said, man, let's put it together. But no, I don't want to cut.
That's what's up. So yes, I can draw. Back in high school days, that's why I want to know how, where you got where your name came from, like Rockbox. Nephew, Mike, that's crazy.
Well, Rockbox, it actually came from a song from Run DMC. I used to jam
Been gang banging most of my life. I started gang banging when I was 16 back in 84, 1985. Believe it or not, man, I was active gang member up until 3 years ago. Even at 45 years old, I was still active in gang banging. You know, you can catch me and Lynn when I'm on this road on it. Any given moment, grown with the gray hair, throwing up the hood and everything, man. But God changed my life, you know what I mean? And I saw my kids growing up, and I got spooked, man, and I didn't want them to take that route. So, you know, everybody knows me. I'm Big Bully, Big Bulldog from Lynn. You know, man, but once I accepted Christ, you know, my pastor, shout out to my pastor, Michael J.T. Fisher, who is also my uncle, and my church, Greatest Iron Church family, the city of Compton, man, they saved my life. And GZ, you know what I mean? He's a member of them now, man. They saved my life. And because I'm the nephew and he's the uncle named Michael, as always, you know, people like Big Michael Fisher, Little Michael Fisher, which I'm a green, but I'm a Fisher offspring. So it's like, well, you nephew, and that's the uncle. So, you know, I adapted that name here. Michael Fisher is known as Jay Kingdom, who is a gospel artist right now, man. So it's just like, man, you know, representing and showing him love that I got his back too. Like, man, I ain't bored. I'm his nephew. I'm nephew.
So talk about these albums that you guys got sitting in front of you.
This is Rabbit Got the Gun. I was asked one time by URG7, what's Rabbit Got the Gun? You know what I mean? And I was like, well, you know what I'm saying? Growing up, we always seen, you know what I'm saying, Elmer Fudd chasing Bugs Bunny. I was like, well, now the rabbit got the gun. You know what I'm saying? And he was like, what? What you mean? What? I didn't know you guys like, yeah, that's what I mean. The rabbit got the gun. Yeah, you know. Michael it's not the same. This ain't, yeah, it's not going to be the same stuff family. That you've been hearing all the time. See? You know? Basically, with the whole album, I just kind of like showcase all my different talents, basically. Because, you know, I'm a beatbox fan, you know what I mean? So, kind of display all the talents I got next to me. And if I should die before I wake, boy, I pray DJ Bobby B, my soul and take, but I still left home when I crossed that street. 16 years old, running wild and free. I didn't care back then. Went from hell to jail and back to hell again. It's pretty good, man. You know, I mean, I'm like, I'm kind of humble. You know what I mean? I'm not a cocky dude or nothing like that. I'd rather show you the time and type of stuff. You know, but what I can say from the feedback that I got from the album, they like it.
Jesus,
Friends, Russia, and he came like he said he's not killed. Also, it's all available on like digital download. Oh, yes, all digital. I'm that soul, man. Amazon, iTunes, Spotify, all that. You know what I'm saying? CD Baby, Lane Distribution. And it's going good, man. I can't complain. Sometimes I'm a little bit overwhelmed.
I've been doing this. Poetry with a rhythm. That's what I call it. I didn't even call it. I say it's a poetry with a rhythm. Do you hear it? You know, and man, ever since, you know, and then when the beatbox part came in, I didn't even know it was called beatboxing then, but maybe like 3 months, you know, say after I started doing it, you know what I'm saying, and people started noticing me, Fat Boys had just won the rap contest up in New York, and Curtis Blow had just picked them up. And I was looking at TV with my sisters, and I was like, man, she like to do that too. She was like, yeah, I know. I was like, man, I have to do that too. I'm gonna keep on now, you know. And as they progress, you know, see, I guess I kind of progress with it. But when I first started off, I was emulating them, you know, the human beatbox. Then it went to Dougie Fresh, Biz Markie, and then. It was a Jockbox from Philadelphia with the Skinny Boys, and who else? Ready Rock C from Philly too. I emulated all them, so by the time I got to like 16 years old, I mastered all of them.
That's right.
So I was like, man, I'm tired of doing that, man. I'm gonna start doing my own thing. So the first thing I started doing when I started doing my own thing was doing stuff that we grew up to, you know, on the West Coast, you know what I'm saying, the Zapta. You know what I'm saying? George Clinton.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? P-Funk All-Stars. One Way. I could go on and on, you know what I'm saying? And then I started making stuff on my own, too. So, you know, that's rock. That's who I am today. And sometimes when they want me to give a description of myself, I say I'm everybody from back then till now because I've been doing it that long. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Across the board.
Everybody. Yeah, I'm
something
here.
Nephew. Tell me about your album.
My album, Belly the Whale, man. It's you know, like I said, man, I transitioned, man. I went from, I didn't want to do the gangster rap no more. You know what I mean? It's like, man, I don't like my kids talking about being turned up, being on mollies, being loaded. Right. I have children. I understand we had our fun, but they might not be able to make it through what I made it through. So, you know, I changed up my music, man. Belly the Whale is really my cry out. That cry out from those like me that's in the gang lifestyle, that's been addicted to drugs, that's been in and out of prison, that we don't see, that don't never get out in the open, that really, you know, like, I found God in a one-man cell looking at life in prison, you know what I mean, where nobody else could see me that little private time, and I actually sit down and pray when nobody can see me. This is the type of stuff that this album is about, man. It's, you know, it shows me going from gangbanging to, I'm a minister now, you know what I mean? I went to college and earned my degree and stuff like that, man. And God has been blessing it. You know, we went to Mexico, to Ensenada, Mexico. You know, and right now I'm getting a lot of plugs and a lot of requests coming in from Too Tight in Japan, and I got different people, man. Old Boy from France I'm finna do a compilation with. They got a Boki Loke on it, and you know, man, we working with URG7. Much love to my boy Big to the Boy from Compton, man. You know, Compton, Watts, Linwood, man, we represent that area, man. And it's just, it's crazy because we went and opened up a show for Second to None and all these cats, man. But it's cool how they embrace it, and guys like Justified, man, they'll bring us in, man, and allow, because you know, he hooked up with me. He still do hip-hop, but I'm like, man, come with me and do something positive, you know, just to do that, man. And they let us open up shows, man, and, you know, set the atmosphere, man.
Right, all the time. That's right.
So I'm listening, I'm like, I want to know what the writing process was for you for that. Like, how did you get all the years of experience of all that from your brain to the pen to the paper? Like, what was that?
Well, man, you know, being a minister, man, and we to prepare sermons, so it's, you know, we have to apply the word of God with testimony with our actual life. So about me knowing being an instrumentalist, about being a drummer, and I did gangster rap, I knew how to put metaphors and stuff together, but what I really wanted to do, man, is sit down. I don't like a lot of people rapping about a life they really don't live. You know, anybody can get up, man, they can come up out of Beverly Hills and emulate a DJ Quick or YG or whatever and rap it. If it's hard and it look good on the camera, but I came to really put my feelings, my real life. It's a lot of pain that went into this.
Yeah, that's one of a kind. This is one of a kind. This is your experience from what, 83? Yeah. You say 83 to now?
Yeah.
I was, what, 2 years old, 3 years old, 83. Man. You know what I'm saying? Right. Right. You know what I mean? Like, you know, from now, like, I want to hear that. Yeah. This is your pain and struggle and your process from changing from what you were to what you are now until you're growing up and doing your thing. Like, you know what I mean? Yeah. Your whole life right here, like, I want to hear that. I want to get in there. Right. Feel, right. I feel that. You know what I mean? That's the shit we're talking about is lyrical content. Yeah. And just, like, putting your heart and your passion into this music. You know, because once you do that, there's nothing. It's going to live eternal. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. You can never be duplicated. Can nobody take you. No, people can try to copy it and they gonna laugh. Like, you know, yeah, you know what I'm saying?
This mixtape is right now. So mixtape factory. .com, man. I'm on Facebook, Nephew Micheal. Check the videos out on YouTube, Nephew Micheal. Jesus is King. We did a tribute, man. One of my homeboys got killed, man. Sadly, you know. By the sheriff or whatever, man, and it caused a big ruckus in our city, man, and it hurt. So we did it as a tribute, but also as an awareness of what really goes on, and it really shows how fast the day can turn on you. Yeah. So you always got to keep your armor of God on, man. You got to stay prayed up because you never know. You can walk out of here playing like we cool and everything is good, and you never know. You hit that corner, man, and be out of here.
Yeah. That's what I got from the video. That's why I was like, I asked you. But I didn't want to get into, like, because it kind of tripped me out. Like, I was watching it, and then it was just like, bam. I was like, what happened?
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? What happened? It was chilling. It was
like, I'm working on the song right now. New music coming out right now, man, where I'm out of the belly of the whale now. I'm on the side of the beach. I'm drying off. I'm ready. It's more of a happy thing and just showing how to make it through, man. And I got a single about to come out called Turnaround. It shows how life turns around for the better. And that's going to be the continuation of that video.
That's right.
One more question.
You guys got your solo albums,
but
you guys gonna do anything together?
Oh, we do it all the time.
You're gonna have a collaborative album.
We collab on songs. We collab on songs, and we'll put those songs on both his CD and mine.
We get
two birds in one stone, man.
That's right.
I'm just looking forward to really working with a lot of other artists. I wanna speaking of that, we also go, man, and speak and give our testimonies at high school.
That's very good.
We just recently went to a high school in Huntington Park.
Yeah, the charter school.
Charter school in Huntington Park, man, with a radio host and actor, Micheal Pharaoh. Shout out to Accelerated Radio.
Accelerated Radio.
Supporting us, man, you know what I mean? Real big time, man. She got me active. I went and tried out to a couple of stage plays that I made it in, man. I went performing arts in my church ministry, man. So that's a lot of doors opening, man, and God is allowing. And you know, I'm 48 years old, man. I've been struggling. I know what it is to work and raise family. So I'm not really tripping off no record deal. I'm not looking for that shine and all that. I'm not 48 years old. My thing is, man, if I can put my testimony down on something that'll attract the streets, that'll attract these youngsters, just maybe, man, if one person, man, can hear my music and it'll change their life, and they get their life to God, I got a better chance of getting in the heaven. That's what this is all about.
When the rapper got the gun, man, y'all need to go on and check it out, man. It's a good CD, man. Like I say, I display most of my talents. I also got another project coming up called Wrong Folk Music Mixtape. It's got a lot of cats from California, Texas, Florida, Mexico now, you know, several spots. And I'm still building on it too. I got maybe like 3/4 of it done, but the 1/4, you know, I'm still trying to do it. And I'm gonna have DJ Bobby B
the same who did my song Payback, first song on Rabbit Got the Gun. Sugar Free DJ, he's going to be doing the mixtape itself.
And I just want to put this out there, man, for those that's listening, man. Coming from the life that I live, you know what I mean? I still deal with a lot. I see OGs with Bloods and Crips and stuff like that. Even in the church house, man, and we talk and we shake hands and we love what each other's doing, man. But I just want to put it out there, man. I think it's about time, man, that we get some of these artists together. Because it is artists that used to live the streets. It's artists that played the game. It's artists that was pimps, players, and hustlers.
That's right.
They don't live that life no more. And we in this music industry, man. I'm putting it out there, man. I would like for Bloods and Crips that's in this music industry, man, to step up, man, and let's get together, man, and collab on another we all in the same game type thing.
Yeah, that's
or,
right.
You know, showing, man, that we just not out here. We just, cause we're losing each other. Mm-hmm. We're losing our community. We're losing our people, man. And we so busy turning up, we're not looking at what we're losing.
Yeah.
So if some of y'all got heart out there, and you Blood, you Crippin', and you in this music industry, man, it can go underground. I don't need no well-known name, folks. It don't matter. Let's get together, man, and do something, man, for this community.
Yeah.
Let's see what your heart, let's see what the real talent is, and not cuss and really give a message that ain't corny. That's really about the street. You know what I mean, man? And I just put that out there, and let God put it on somebody's spirit to join in, man, and let's do something.
Put it out there in the world. You know what I mean? God will take care of it. What you're trying to do is you're trying to get the people together. And even if it doesn't go mainstream and all that, but it's still the positive vibe and the action of people have that experience in their life and understand.
And if we do it from our heart, man, I believe God will bless it. If we do it from our heart, man, and we really out there, man, I believe God will bless
it. Like right now, my whole deal is that, you know, everybody always got something to say about, you know what I'm saying, hip hop and how the youngsters are doing it today or whatever. But me, myself, I'm not complaining. I'm not the show. So that's where I'm at. I'm trying to show them. Something that we didn't elaborate on, too. We represent Ryan Rocket Entertainment. You know what I'm saying? Which is here, you'll see the logo on there. And Ryan Rock Entertainment just is not a label. It's all we also promote. We do anything that got to do with entertainment that I can wear a hat for, basically. Or he can, or whatever, or urge, you know what I'm saying? We associate with his side of entertainment, too. And, you know, like I say, I'm a humble dude, so I'm not a real brat. You know, if you wanted to hear me, you're going to have to hear me on the mic. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, that's where I come out. You know, but right now I like to chill. And then another thing, too, I wanted to say. All y'all people out there, you know, all y'all artists out there, you know, I'll be out there with y'all doing those shows and everything like that. Let's quit looking at each other as competition. And let's get together and let's put West Coast back on the map, man.
Start promoting each other.
Yeah, promoting each other. And shout out to Loyalty Clothing, you know what I'm saying? They sponsor us. Shout out to Street Props, too. You know what I'm saying? Trace Unos, Pegaso, Lito P, you know what I mean?
C-Pool. Shout out to Urge 7.
Yeah, Urge 7. And another deal, too, I want to say something, too, referencing that. I've been on Urge for a while, and then come to find out we was in the same mix back in the day and didn't even know it. You know, and I'm talking about early 80s. You know what I'm saying? We was both in Compton out there with Dub C and the DJ Aladdin and FaZe and Frank and, you know what I'm saying, all them out there at the same time. You know what I mean? They didn't even know it until we hooked up. And we was recipients of the 2015 Indie Artist Award.
Concho, appreciate you, man, for
shout
that.
Shout out to Concho Promotions. And at the time, me and Urge had one arm together, so we was up there together. And I think I had finished performing or something, and he pulled my coattail outside. He was like, man, Box, I'm doing this and doing that, man. You got to come to the house, man. He was
traveling all the way from
we came from there. You know what I'm saying?
We come from Linwood to Africa to go see a Urge.
Yeah, man. We came out to see him, man. You know what I'm saying? So I came out to see him.
Yeah.
And he broke it down to me on what was going on. I was like, man, I'm here.
I mean, right.
You know what I'm saying? Next time I brought Nephew with me, man, and it has been nonstop.
Straight up blessing.
So don't be sleeping on Earth 7, man. Don't be sleeping on K.I.D. Don't be sleeping on Angel Sandoval and Sir Black. You know what I'm saying? And
y'all messed up because we all in the building together. So what's coming up out of here? What's coming up out of here today? It's going to change the world.
That's right.
See, y'all start preaching on you.
Yeah, that's right. It's all like a funky song. You know what I mean?
Thank you guys for coming by.
All right.
Shout out to Hungry.
Baby. That's right. Yeah. All right. Much love, man.
Mr. Fairy Tale lover, don't have to lie to hang. Do your own thing, that grown thing. I trust the wrong person if you want to. How you tuck in your tail? Souls for sale, don't tell me your paper in the mail. No twist, that's my get down. Hey, say what you mean. Wear a rubber in my sleep. Don't trust them rat in my jeans. Suckers deviate the plan, selfish thoughts all the time. Straight sneaking and creeping, contemplating no mind. Hell, get your own, I don't condone others in my zone. Once you once, maybe twice, after three, then I'm gone. Process, eliminate the story, ends one day. Wanna use my skill just to earn my pay. Lord, have mercy.
I never knew a love like this. Fist stabbed in the back by friends. I'm in need of a change. I'm here on my own. Took a stand, had to be that man. And realized that it's all this plan. I confess with my mouth that Jesus is King.
Come on. Micheal the Nephew. I done been on a block where the G's at. Too busy running from the cops with a weed bag. Too many of us died over small things, blinded by the voodoo or the drugs or the gangbang. But God prevails, the Lord Almighty sent his only son to save those just like me. I'm tired of fighting, my own demons got me nailed to the wall. But God, now I'm screaming time after time, mess over mess. While I'm happy in the spirit, I'm bound to the flesh. Holy Spirit, come and walk with your boy. I don't need to be the victim. I don't want to hit the flow. It's late night, dick night, trick me. Calling little boys in the hood, want to be a big baller. I got to thank God that I'm still here. I give a sermon, give a word, but I'm still here. Ah.
Hey, hey. Rock box in the house. Who the hell talking about a trap, misusing out of tunes and disrespect the zap? Yeah, I'm here to put Linwood on the map, plus bring this hip-hop back. What? It's the Mucha Grande, Senor, Kimo Sabe, living off this hip-hop. Remember, was a hobby, newbie, I'm a grown man, Tamayama old man, self-preservated, plus I did it with my own hands. Before we started, some say it, I say I got Earth 7 CD debut, future text in the mail, the new David, can lick and lie up at the dryer again, like Noah building an ark. Daniel in the lion did an aggressive lick, as I spit, is the ultimate rhyme. Riding a troop beside it, the best that it gets. From Cali to Mexico, you're hearing the best of all. It's the Rock Box here to let you know. Ryan rocking for life.
Box. about to go for real right now. Save it. We about to go.
Oh, shit. Right now. All right, damn. All right. I'll be talking again.